That's a real Australian greeting. No matter where you go in Australia, you will get that greeting, the how you going, mate. But I notice it depends on where you go and the temperature of the area that you're in Australia on the how you going, mate, that you receive, right? You go up to somewhere like Brisbane or anywhere in Queensland, actually, and you'll get the head kick with it too. It's like, how you going, mate? You go up to the Northern Territory where it's really hot, it's like, how you going, mate? You get down to Melbourne where it's a bit colder, it's like, how you going, mate? You get down to Tasmania, it's just, eh. Went to this town, I feel like I got to tell you guys about it, this town called Glen Rowan. It's where Ned Kelly and his gang were shot and captured. And we drove into this town, there's no one in the town, except for this massive building called Ned Kelly's Last Stand Experience. I thought, got to take a look in there. This old dude behind the counter, best sale technique I've ever seen in my life, right? The moment I step foot in there, this old guy just starts going off. He's like, hey, son, chap, buster, you listen up here, bottlenose. This is a $4.4 million extravaganza, all right? There is nothing else like this in the world. It's a recreation of Ned Kelly's Last Stand via animatronics. After paying the admission fee, you'll swear that you're in the presence of bush rangers. That's how real this experience is. And after paying the $18 admission, I'm like, wow, it's so true. I feel like I've been robbed. So I often do get confused for someone famous quite often. You probably guessed it tonight when I walked out on stage. Yes, that's right. Tom Cruise. Right, maybe this will convince you. Here we go. Tom Cruise. There's a guy who's coming out from America and he's got a TV show called Crossing Over with John Edward. You heard of this guy, right? Yeah, you reckon he's for real? No. Well, a lot of people believe in this guy because he gets a massive audience together of people that are wanting to contact their deceased loved ones. And he's somewhat of a medium, a go-between. Apparently, he's able to cross over into the afterlife and communicate thoughts of the dead back to the living. And everyone's amazed at this, that he can get so many things so spot on. But I agree with you folks here tonight. I got this guy, John Edward, figured out. If you actually listen to him talk, you'll notice he goes at such a rapid pace. He throws out so many different ideas and scenarios. It's like, yeah, eventually something. It's going to stick. Right? It's going like he's some auctioneer. He's like, now I see a lady in the audience. I see a lady in the audience who has recently lost a loved one. Now we're getting somewhere. I see she's lost her significant other. I see a gold watch. Do we have a gold watch? I see a brooch, a pendant, a bracelet, a necklace. Lady down the back. We have a necklace. I see this necklace. It was a gift, Greg. It was a birthday gift, a wedding gift, anniversary gift, engagement gift. Just a gift. All right. I see the letter V. I see the name Vanessa. He says, hello, Vanessa. That is your name, correct? Vanessa. No, it's not. You know someone called Vanessa? You work with someone called Vanessa? You're somewhere associated with someone called Vanessa? You went to school with someone called Vanessa. Okay, then. That's who he says hello to. Hello, Vanessa from school. Take my word for it, lady. I see he had a mysterious death, though, Greg. He was in a plane crash, a car crash. He was run over by a bus, a dump truck. He fell off a cliff. He was attacked by piranha while traveling along the Amazon. No, he was murdered. He was stabbed. He was shot. He was hung. He was well hung. Okay. See why you miss him. He was strangled, suffocated, poisoned. No, I got it. He was killed with the canister golder in the library by Colonel Plum. Sword to the gullible lady in the pink sweater. The most realistic balloon animal you'll have ever seen. Check this out. Giraffe.
Check it out!
Ah! Now I'm going to attempt to put my entire body through this tennis racket.
Right back now, the Funk Soul Brother.
That's me, Doug, Funk Soul Brother.